In this video, I will talk about how to formulate a type of linear programming problem called the production process problem. Let's see an example. A company uses raw material, RM, and labor to produce 4 types of products. The company can purchase at most 2,000 units of raw material per week. They have 6,000 labor hours available per week. These 4 types of products are Product 1, P1, Product 2, P2, Luxury Product 1, L1, and Luxury Product 2, L2. We assume the demand for these products are unlimited. Processing 1 unit of raw material will need 1 hour of labor and yield 3 units of Product 1 and at the same time 4 units of Product 2. If we further spend $5 and 3 hours to process 1 unit of Product 1, we'll get 1 unit of Luxury Product 1. If we further spend $4 and 2 hours to process 1 unit of Product 2, we will get 1 unit of Luxury Product 2. The purchasing price of raw material is $3 per unit. The selling prices of Product 1 and Product 2 are $7 and $6 per unit, respectively. The selling prices of Luxury Product 1 and Luxury Product 2 are $17 and $16 per unit, respectively. We want to maximize the company's weekly profit. The key step for this type of problem is to determine how the outputs from a later stage of the process are related to the outputs from an earlier stage. In order to calculate the profit, we need to know how much raw material should be purchased, and how many of each type of product should be sold. Therefore, we define X raw material as the units of raw material processed weekly, X product 1 as the units of product 1 sold weekly, and so on. With these definitions, the profit is equal to the revenues minus the costs. The total revenue is equal to the sum of the unit selling price times the quantity of each type of product. The total cost is equal to the raw material cost plus the further processing cost. The raw material cost is equal to the unit purchasing price times the quantity of the raw material. The further processing cost is equal to the unit processing cost times the quantity of each type of luxury product. As for the constraints, we know no more than 2,000 units of raw material can be purchased weekly. No more than 6,000 labor hours can be used each week. X raw material represents the total labor hours needed to process the raw material to get product 1 and product 2. 3 times X luxury product 1 is the total labor hours needed to further process product 1 to get luxury product 1. 2 times X luxury product 2 is the total labor hours needed to further process product 2 to get luxury product 2. All the decision variables are greater than or equal to 0. This is the initial formulation. Is this formulation complete? No, we still have some important relations that are not considered yet. Each unit of raw material yields 3 units of product 1 and 4 units of product 2. If later we decide to further process 1 unit of product 1, we can get 1 unit of luxury product 1. But the sum of product 1 and luxury product 1 is still 3 times raw material. Similarly, if later we decide to further process 2 units of product 2, we can get 2 units of luxury product 2, but the sum of product 2 and luxury product 2 is still 4 times raw material. Therefore, we need these 2 constraints. This is the complete problem formulation. This is the optimal solution. That means we need to purchase 2,000 units of raw material, sell 6,000 units of product 1, 6,000 units of product 2, 0 units of luxury product 1, 2,000 units of luxury product 2, and the max profit is $96,000 per week. What if we change the problem a little bit? Each unit of raw material yields 3 units of product 1 or 4 units of product 2. In this case, we can assume X raw material 1 is the amount of the raw material that is used to make product 1, and X raw material 2 is the amount of the raw material that is used to make product 2. Now this will also be changed to X raw material 1, and this will also be changed to X raw material 2. We have an additional relation. The portion of the raw material used to make product 1 plus the portion of the raw material used to make product 2 is equal to the total amount of the raw material. Combining these three equations, we will have this new constraint. This is the new problem formulation. This constraint replaced the previous two constraints. This is the optimal solution. That means we need to purchase 2,000 units of raw material, sell 6,000 units of product 2, 2,000 units of luxury product 2, and the max profit is $54,000 per week. Okay, that is how to formulate the production process problem. Thanks for watching.